Hi friends, welcome to Knowledge Share. Today in this video, we are going to see how to handle large list items without triggering the throttling issue using PNP in SharePoint frame. So today, a lot of customers using SharePoint online has millions and millions of items, files in SharePoint. I hope everyone are aware that SharePoint online list can hold millions of items. But the real problem is how to programmatically retrieve these items. Either it can be in SharePoint framework or in any other coding models. How to retrieve it without triggering the throttling issue? The throttling limit is said to be 5,000. You can't change the limit. If it is on-premise, you will be able to change it. But since it is SharePoint online, you cannot change the throttling limit. So that is what we are going to learn, how we can handle the throttling issue and how we can programmatically retrieve more than 5,000 items from the list. Let's see a demo and let us have a hands-on, shall we? So here I have a list called Swift Master, which has around 14,284 items. So we are going to see how we can retrieve items from this Swift Master with different scenarios. If you see the Swift Master, there are multiple columns. So the Swift number is unique, so it won't be repeated in this list. The branch is the metadata column, managed metadata, and business segment is, it's a choice column. So it has only two segments, GC and JC and MT. So if we filter it via GC, it should return around 10,000 items. And if you filter using Swift number, it should return only one item because since it is a unique. To explain the scenario in an easy way, I'll be swapping between the SharePoint site and Visual Studio Code. Don't worry. So I have provided the repo link in the video description. You can always go to my GitHub repo and then you can always refer the code. So this is the web part. So I have developed this web part with a few buttons to explain different scenarios. So it is not deployed. It is currently running. Okay. So the first thing is, let me open the developer tool so that you can see what's going on. So first is get all items. So when I press this link, so all the 14,000 plus items should be returned. Okay, so the moment when I press this link, you can see in the network there are different transaction calls going on with the SharePoint list, each with 2000 items as a top. So for get all items, I am using PNP get all. So I'll be showing the code in a couple of seconds. So that is just one line of code, but on the back end, they are internally calling the SharePoint list with every 2000 items via paging, and they will also include the last item ID. So if you see the console, all the 14,284 items are returned. So moving on to the code. So this is the all item. So here you can see it's just a one line of code. So the target list, I have declared the target list here. And I'm just getting the list and then I'm just using get all function. So if you are using the get all, it will return all the items. And that is how it is returning all the 14,384 items. Sorry, 284 items. Okay. So let us see how it can be paged. So there are also features available in PNP where you can use the paging feature. So now when I click this, before that I will clear this network, I'll also clear the console. So now when I click this PNP paged all items, you can see now it is going to fetch all the items, but instead of get all, I have used a different one, and you can see it returns the same all the items, 14,284. And if you see the code, So this is something we are using get paged. You can go until 4,500 or 5,000 items, because more than 5,000 is the throttling limit, but the best recommended way is to fetch every 2,000 items. So here what I'm trying to do is, I'm just going to use the do while loop, and here I have declared the paged item collection as undefined first, and then if it is undefined, then get the top 22,000 item with the get paged. So if you see the request, the first request is this one, and if you see, you can see a next link. It will return the 2,000 items, and there will also be a next link. So this is where there will be a query string to the next 2,000 item with the last item ID. So we can use this next link, and then until the next link is present, fetch the next 2,000 item. So the same, I am just using the method items.getNext. So automatically what it will do is, it will pass the next link and get the next 2,000 items. So it will go on until it has the next link. So once it doesn't have the next link and it reaches the end of the item, then it will come out of the do while loop. So inside the do while loop, I am just concatenating all the results into one array, one big array, and that is what the final items, and that is what it is displayed here. Okay, the next is, we are going to use the same paged item method, but this time we are filtering it using business segment, which is equal to GC. So for this GC segment, it should approximately return more than 10,000 items. So let's see what happens. So I'll clear the network, I'll clear the console. So now when I press this page search, oops, it didn't return an items. Instead, it threw out an error. So if you see the error, it is throttling. The same method we used it to get all the items around 14,000, but it returned good. But the same we are using it to filtering, use it with a filter, it returned throttle. That is because the paged item works only without the filtering. So please don't use the paged items with filtering. So I'll discuss the normalized approach in the later part. Okay, let's see other scenarios. The next is normal SIF number search using the filter operation. So I am just searching a SIF number with a normal filter operation. So let us see what happens. Just clear the console. And this is PNP filter with SIF number. So it returned an item. So this is a normal filter operation, where you can see the payload is, we are passing the filter. The next is using the camel query. So it also returns the items. If you see, the camel query filter also returned the same item. And if you see the network, the payload is, we are just passing the camel query. The camel query is just a normal camel query, which is filtering using the SIF number. So it also returned an item. So if you see the code, this is the normal filter operation, and this is the camel query, where I have declared the camel query here. SIF number search, this is where the camel query is. So basically here I am just using the handlebar to template, and then passing the parameter SIF number, getting the query, and then appending it in the view XML. After that, I am just using the method called get items by camel query. So it is returned. It has returned the item. The next is PNP filter with segment. So here, the same way how we have filtered the SIF number, I am just going to filter it using the business segment. Okay, let us see what happens. So let me clear the network and the console. So now when I click this, it returned the same error, which is throttling. And if I use the SCAML query, same throttling. See, business segment, GC, a simple query, but it throws throttling, same. So if you see the code, this is a normal filter operation and this is the CAML query. CAML query is segment search. So this is what I am using, the CAML query, but it threw error. So how to search, how to overcome these scenarios, how to overcome this throttling issue? So there is a very simple way of executing it. So let us see the output first. Then I will explain how we can code it. Okay. Let me clear the console and the network. So the last button, which is a normalized CAML query filter with segment. So when I press this, you can see it is running a few transaction get items query and then it will return the result. If you see, around 10,595 records has been returned whose segment is GC, and you can also see the minimum ID and the maximum ID. So for every 2000 records, I'm just searching it for the segment as GC, and then I'm just returning it, collating the items and then retaining it as a one big final array. So let us see how to achieve this. So here I'm just passing it search large list. I'm just passing the query. If you see the query has three parameters: minimum ID, maximum ID, and then the actual business logic filters. So we need the business segment. So minimum ID and maximum ID. So the minimum ID parameter, which should be greater than or equal to the field ID, and the maximum ID parameter, which should be less than the field ID. So this is the compulsory filter which is required, and after this filter you can include your own business logics, whether you need only the business segment or if you want to filter it using multiple fields, you can include all the filters after this condition. Okay, so this is the CAML query I am using it, and this is the search large list. So what basically I am doing is I am just declaring a minimum ID number and the maximum ID variable, and I am just getting the maximum ID, the last item ID of the list. So I am just triggering a method called getMaxID for list, whereby I am just getting the top first item order by ID as false. It will return the last ID of the list. So using that last ID, I am just creating a page based on the predefined page size. For example, if the last return ID is 14,284, then 14,284 by, I have declared the page size as 2000. So by 2000, it almost returns 7 to 8 pages. So that is the maximum page. So for each page, I'm just declaring the minimum ID. So the minimum ID, which starts with 1, and then the maximum ID is, which starts with 2000, which ends with 2000. So I am just passing the minimum ID and then the maximum ID and then the actual search value to the CAML query. So if you see the CAML query, for the first time, if you see the payload, the query will be 1 to 2000. Filter the items from 1 to 2000 and then in that 1 to 2000 check for the business segment as GC. So that is what it is doing the first thing. And once it got the result, concatenate. So I have already declared a final array. So I will concatenate all the results into the final array. So and then I am just checking whether the for loop it is maxed out or not. It is more than the maximum page I have declared it or not. If it is more than, for example, if the for loop is the I starts with 0 and the maximum page is 7. So once it hit 8, it will come out of the loop. So that is what I have declared it here. And until 8, it will send the minimum ID and the maximum ID. And if you see here, the second query, which will send the maximum minimum ID as 2001 and the maximum ID as 4000. So in this way, we are just checking each 2000 records and then we are using our own filters and then we are getting the results. So this is the most efficient way of getting the filtered items without hitting the throttling limit. So based on your total number of items present in the list, the performance may vary. So as of now, I have 14,000 items. It returned within 2 to 3 seconds. And you can increase this limit maybe 2000 to 4500. But I recommend using 2000. But you can increase until 4500, below 5000. So if you increase from 2000 to 5000 means you can reduce the transaction call, but slightly it will take some time to search and then return it. So mostly it will be returned within 5 to 10 seconds. It's based on if you have more than 20,000 or a million of items, then it will take some time, but it will return the results. It won't hit the throttling limit. So this is how you can overcome the throttling limit. I hope you have learned something from here. So always you can refer the code in my repo. The link to the repo is given in the video description. Please feel free to comment or like this video. I hope you like this video. Thank you. Thank you for your time. Have a good day.